Hi guys, how are you? Hope you are doing good. Welcome back to the channel. Stay safe and stay at home. Let us discuss about the growth stages of the groundnut. Before going to the discussion, if you are new to this channel, please like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to click on the bell icon for the further notifications. And let us discuss about the growth stages of the groundnut. First, growth stages of the groundnut. The growth stages of the groundnut plants, based on the visual observations of the vegetative and the reproductive growth, there are two stages in any crop for the growth stages, like a vegetative phase and a reproductive phase. Let us discuss about the phases of the vegetative and reproductive detailedly in this video, and let us see some of the system of staging the groundnut plants was proposed by Booty. Some of the stages we'll be observing here. A groundnut is a self-pollinated annual and herbaceous legume belonging to the subfamily Papilionaceae of the family Leguminaceae. Here, the groundnut belongs to the family Leguminaceae, and it is the self-pollinated crop as we know, and annual herbaceous legume. It comes under the legumes crop, so it is coming under the family Leguminaceae family. And let us see about the structure of the groundnut plants. Plant is erect or prostrate, and you can see the spacely hairy and 15 to 60 centimeters tall. And the growth, the groundnut scientific name is Hyraces hyposia, which describes the particular trait of the species. The meaning of the Hyraces hyposia will be like hypo means under, Asia means ground. Below the ground, how the growth has been occurring in the groundnut, here you can observe in this video. And the special feature of the groundnut is that the fruit begins as a fertilized flower above the ground, but the pod occurs below the ground and the seed mature in the ground. This is the special feature of the groundnut. Let us see and discuss about the stages of the groundnut, which was proposed by the Booty 1982. Let us see some of the stages of the groundnut described by the Booty 1982. First stage is VE, which is emergence stage. And emergent stage, here you can observe the cotyledons near the soil surface with some of part of the seedling visible. And V0, cotyledons flat and open at the below the soil surface. And V1, first trifoliate can be occurred. And this all stages you can observe one by one in this video, and you can know about detailedly. And VN stage, end developed nodes on the main axis, and retrofoliate node is counted when its leaflets are unfurled and flat. Coming to the reproductive stages, growth stages, here you can observe the bloom, peg, pod, full pod stage, beginning seed stage, fruit seed, beginning maturity, and harvest maturity, over pod maturity. This will be discussed detailedly in the slide. You can observe that vegetative stages are based on number of nodes and the main stem with cotyledonary nodes. You know what are the cotyledons of the crop, and what is the vegetative stages comes under the crop. The next one is the node of the first true leaf. A trifoliate leaf occurs, and the leaflets at this node have developed a point that they are unfurled and flat. Then the plant is at V1 stage. The additional main stem stages and nodes, and therefore V stages, are counted as soon as leaflets at those nodes are unrolled and flat. The reproductive stages are based on visually observable events like flowering, pigging, and fruit growth and development. Let us see some of stages. As we discussed before, these are the reproductive stages of the groundnut: R1, R2 pegging, R3 podding, R4 full pod, or phase starting of the seedling, R6 full seed of the groundnut, R7 mature seed, R8 harvest maturity, R9 over mature part. Let us see one by one. Let us discuss the emergence stage, and this is the stage of the emergence of the groundnut. How it is coming out of the ground? The groundnut take about 3 to 5 days for the germination after the sowing, and the emergence from the soil at 30 degrees Celsius. The main optimal temperature for the emergence and germination of the groundnut is 30 degrees Celsius, and the radical emergence within 24 hours or earlier for vigorous Spanish types, and within the 36 to 48 hours in virginal types. We have two types of the groundnut. Varieties like Spanish types and virginal types. The primary root system is the tap roots, but the many lateral roots also appear about 3 days after the germination. First, you should observe that the groundnut takes 3 to 5 days for the germination and emergence from the soil. Next stage. Here you can observe the reproductive stages with the images, how they are reproducing to the stages. Like here you can see the beginning of the bloom, beginning of pegging, how the pegging has been started, beginning pod from the beginning stage, how the pod has been occurring. You can observe here, and full pod stage or four stage beginning seed, how it mature. And here these are some of the pictures of the reproductive stages of the groundnut, and here you can see the beginning of the bloom. The bloom about 30 days after the emergence, and the peanut plants begin to produce flowers. The flower number will continue to increase until the plant reaches peak bloom about 60 to 70 days after the emergence, and then the flower development will begin to the decline. So the important point is that 60 to 70 days it takes for the blooming after the emergence. This is the main point, and bloom about 30 days after the emergence. And the most peak stage means the 60 to 70 days, and first flowering can be started at 30 days after the emergence. Next stage is beginning peg. What is meant by peg? Peg means it is a stalk-like structure where it is called peg, becomes visible within 4 to 6 days after the fertilization under the optimal conditions. The peg extension, here you can see that peg extension is slow at first and takes about 5 to 6 days to penetrate the bracts. Once the pegs are 3 to 4 mm long, they become positively geotropic, means they are going inside the soil. The gynophore is commonly referred to as peg, as you can observe here, and the peg carrying the ovary pushes itself into the soil. It is only after entering the soil that ovary begins to develop and takes up the horizontal position, and the peg typically reaches and penetrates the soil surface in about 8 to 14 days after the fertilization. And let us the beginning pod stage. This is the beginning of the pod stage, and the peg carrying the ovary. Here you can see that peg which is carrying the ovary pushes itself into the soil, and it is only after emerging the soil that ovary begins, as we discussed before. At the same time, the pod also begins to enlarge, and the growth stages of the pod has been increased. You can observe the full pod stage, where the full pod stage means the R4 stage. It is defined as the 50% of the plants have been achieved fully expanded pods. 50% has been expanded, and the pods become countable, and pods weighs about measured to 60 to 70 days after the planting. The pod number per plant raises rapidly to the maximum at 80 to 120 days, depending upon the cultivar and botanical type. And if you see about the next stage, beginning seed stage, where beginning seed stage has during the growth phase, that is R5 growth stage, when the seed cotyledon growth is visible in at least one pod on 50% of the plants. The endocarp reduces, recedes as the ovule grows, and they disappear completely by the time of seeds are matured. Here you can observe some of the images like a full seed, beginning maturity, and mature pod, how it looks like, and overripe pod, how it is looking. And these are some of the stages of the growth stages of the groundnut, which are discussed in detail.
If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon.